Again, as you can see, I am the supreme hunter in the game because I have killed a moose and also killed a deer, another deer, and probably another deer. Actually, to be honest, I didn't kill any of them. I think they all got killed by a snake. Four animals, four deers and mooses got killed by a snake. Actually killed a snake over here. See, I killed it. There must be some kind of a bug with, I don't know, the game right now because it's... Can't explain it, but it appears like that the snakes are killing all the animals without any problems, or this might just be a weird game. As you can see, I brought my mushroom collection and I wanted to make a nice steak dinner, but looks like we have to make do with what we have right now. Let's eat the cooked ones for some morale. Yeah, really unexpected turn of events. I mean, sometimes you get lucky in the game, that's fine, I guess. So let's take over the antlers. By the way, this is a this is a video for something else. I wanted to go into the graveyard. And we'll do just that. Fatty meat. We have a few pelts around, but I think we can come back after them later. Now let's just go to the Musty Grave. I'll show you the grave digging options, sort of thing. So right now we're playing as the graveyard keeper, except that instead of burying bodies, we'll actually fight bodies and skeletons. Okay, wolf. Yeah, make sure there is only one wolf, or there, at least that you fight them one at a time. Well, I'm full of meat and other types of food, so no. No, no. Don't go straight into the wolf horde, that's a big mistake. It looks like the coast is clear. Yeah, I'm almost level 5. It was a hard journey, but I think I can kill everything except the skeletons. So if the skeletons get a quick drop on me, or if I don't land my skills right, I'll probably be dead. The necromancer fight is not so hard, but the skeletons are the ones that really, really get you. You don't really need a shovel to grave dig, because you get a shovel once you arrive here. Come on, shovel, where are you? Or is it the shovel is randomly generated? Sometimes I... Yeah, there was a shovel right here. I played the game a couple of times and died, of course, to the skeletons, and there was a shovel right here. Well, I guess if there is no shovel, I can just use my own shovel, but let's search around a little more. Yeah, apparently there is no shovel this time. So even that is randomly generated. So yeah, you can buy the shovel for about 50 gold or something. And the cool thing about it is that it never breaks. So that means you can use it to smash pots. So it's good that it's a secondary weapon. Okay, welcome to Graveyard Keeper, another game I loved. Now, let's see if we can... Get away, skeleton. I have to use this as a container for the meat. I'm really curious if you can store the meat here. I mean, it will basically be a 10 minute... Actually, it will be kind of like a 30 minute wait for the meat. And then I'll just have to go back and come back for it after I finish the dungeon, because this is a huge supply of food. Yeah, in case you're wondering, it does lower your sanity a bit, or morale, so 75-55. Look at this, okay. The meat can stay there, it's safe, no one will try to eat it because they think it's a corpse in there. 76-55. It does lower both your morale and your sanity, so I really, really recommend you only search the graves after you finish the dungeon. So let's go and finish the dungeon, otherwise the morale and the sanity penalty will be huge and we'll get a lot of debuffs. By the way, the only reason I don't have a shield right now is because I spent all that money to get the skill book for the Maces level 2. So yeah, that's why I don't have a shield. The dual build is really, really weird in the game. Until they get the dual wielding up, it's not really worth it because you get a lot of debuffs and penalties. Now I'm curious about the combat mastery. Do you have something for dual wielding? Because I never saw it or never looked at it. This is a good one, right on target. Oh, this is a very, very good passive. Okay, let's enter the dungeon. Usually, right now with your dual wield, you only do a little bit of extra damage. And your chances to do stuff are slight increased. For example, let's say... Good chance... 12%. But it also lowers your day's chance, so be careful when you dual wield. Unless you know what you're doing or are just over-leveled, it will not work. Ho ho! That was a great shovel hit. As you can see, it doesn't drain the durability because it doesn't have any durability. The developers might want to fix this as well. So we have the snake problem killing all the wildlife. And we have the shovel problem, which is used to grave. It's used to dig graves and also smash everything. Okay, here he comes. This is the guy that killed me. First of all, I want him to fumble a lot more. Now, this was unsuspectingly easy. Okay, now I also have to think about what title to give to this video because... If I add graveyard or graveyard digging, it will sound weird and probably I'll get demonetized. Okay, that was my mistake. Whew, these skeleton fights are way harder than they seem. Especially now in the beginning because I don't have any Vivifang potions with me or anything else. Not that I use them, but hey. It's good to have as a backup. Look at him resting with a shovel in his hand. They also appear to have reduced the number of traps in these catacombs. Well, hello there. Little mage, you're about to go down. So, yeah, why not? Let's not take any risks. He dropped a bone for me. Sure, I can keep that as a souvenir. Okay, the end of the dungeon is here. Sorry I'm not speaking too much, but sometimes I just have to focus on the game. Because that's the way you get killed in this one. So how is my body part? Oh, it's okay. I mean, the leg is a little beat up. He's a madman with that shovel. Destroying all the pots with it. Okay, let's make him fumble and maybe stun him. The pain is not too bad, especially when I can heal it. So yeah, right now the game is in a very good position to actually be played because with the extra content it's about 10 hours of content if you start again. And you have to start again. Okay, golden tooth. I guess we are the graveyard dentist. That's another profession we can add to the resume. And undead don't really mind about, you know, feeling pain and stuff like that. The game is so easy to make, I don't know, to make a collection. How about someone If I had the space, I would make a gold tooth collection just because I want a gold tooth for every skeleton that I kill. That would be something, right? Also, where are the benches or the rifles? I forgot what they are called. Even this little guy will pose a lot of problems. So, with my crit chance increased, yeah, this should be pretty easy. Except that I'm in a lot of pain right now and I need to rest to get away from the pain. This sounds like real life. You need to rest to get away from the pain. Okay, fully clear this level of the dungeon. Now let's go down. And it only gets harder and harder after the Aedes. But if there is no skeleton, paladin or crazy stuff like that, it should be fine. Where is my water bag? Did I accidentally throw it away? Hold on a second. Did I put it in the grave by accident? Otherwise I'll be forced to drink the good wine and I don't want to do that. Could be a choice, but I don't really want to drink a lot of alcohol while I'm graveyard digging and also graveyard exploring. Oh yeah, the small ghouls come out of night. They seem a little stronger. Oh, that was such a big mistake from my part. I need to be more careful. Now let's get back into the crypt because it's not safe outside here. Phew. Remember kids, you can't drink gold, so always have supplies ready. Now something really bad happened to me. Hey, I could afford to drink all the alcohol, but not good. Not a good idea. Okay, we're patched up and ready for the next floor of the dungeon. Ready as in, I hope I don't die already. Why are you so hungry? Okay, perfect. Now let's go down. Whew. Good thing I have a good memory and if I make a mistake, I remember where I made the mistake. Now, go, go, go. This will also be a two-trip journey because I have to come back for all that meat and pelts and good stuff. Okay. Ooh, all that graph. That's a pretty good one. As you can see, the loot is good here, but it's not worth, you know, wasting your life away or throwing your life away for that. Yeah, at this point, the best course of action at this point would be to go back, get all the meat and loot from the grave, go back to Osbrook, buy a shield, a buckler, a dueling buckler, or whatever it's called, and come back and kill the skeletons. This will be grisly. This will be so hard. Oh, hey, that's always so tough to kill, especially with this amount of pain. Oh man, I really need my better armor. Actually, died to a skeleton the other time I played and I had good armor. I found an armor with 5 protection in the graveyard. But sadly, I died while a skeleton was angry at me. Spooky, scary, angry skeletons. Let's wait for the pain to drop a little bit, because it will increase my fumble chance. Also, I take extra damage, so pain is not really a joke right now, so be careful. La la la. Okay, enough of that. Great, I'm also almost out of food and I don't want to eat the raw meat outside. Yeah, plus there is the small ghoul problem during the night. Oh, this will be a real test of my abilities. Remember, you can run away when he does the shield thing. So don't be afraid. So let's see. He has 50% HP left. That's still a little too dangerous for my taste. Go, go, go. Yeah, I don't think he's coming. So let's heal up a bit. Let the pain go away again. Man, this is sure different. Broken bones, yeah, they're all broken. I'm actually debating if it's good if... Oh, it's totally smashed. This shield is totally smashed. Yeah. I would have liked to use it. This pain is getting out of hand. Maybe I should have kept some of the supplies I had from earlier with the pain treatment. Okay, we can't be distracted by that. Let's move on. Push forward. Peekaboo. Also, there seem to be almost no traps in here. Very useful, actually, because the more time you spend healing, the less time you have to... Okay, that's scary. The more time you spend healing, the less time you have to explore and finish the dungeon before your food and water runs out. Of course, this is a problem only in the beginning, but the beginning part of the game is the hardest. Okay, so we actually managed to kill that skeleton by healing up to maximum 2 times almost. I hope I don't find another one of those armored skeleton warriors with the axe. The Viking skeletons. Or the skeletal... Oh. Here they are. Such a tough fight, come on. At least this, okay, this is still not usable. Maybe they should really do something with the shields. At least they have to be usable. But the block saved me so many times. I'm pretty sure this is useless. Yeah, let's throw it away. So if you want to get a mace without buying it, this is the perfect place to come. Just don't get killed, you know. Okay, this seems like the right place to go. Okay, we find the lower entrance. Now let's go and explore the rest of the dungeon, because the loot here is amazing most of the times. Also, the dangers are amazing as well. actually stun the ghost? Well, that's amazing. Also, remember, the ghost is one of the enemies that can actually kill you, even if you have good armor. But if you hit it a couple of times, it will just go away. It's something like, you know, it gets bored of fighting us. Okay, so far so good. I probably have 1000 gold at least here. So I need to check that out. Okay, we're in a pretty good condition to fight the lower monsters. Just no paladins, no paladins. Whatever you do, don't give me paladins. Okay, even more gold. Now I can actually afford the shield. As I said, the best course of action in this point would be for me to just leave the place and go to fetch the buckler. So, sanity and morale 55. Okay, destroy that. Okay, that lowers my sanity quite a bit. Now we have to make sure we don't go insane. Okay, skeleton, you have to open the door for me. What was that? That was a huge hit. Okay, where did he hit me most of the times? In the torso. I'm almost tempted to heal up the leg as well, but let's just wait here for a moment. If I remember correctly, I don't have any food left. Ah, well, we can just drink water. Because in this dungeon, you don't find food when you destroy stuff. So I guess I have to remember to bring a lot more food in these types of dungeons. Okay, let's... actually, if I don't explore and take all the stuff now, it will be only harder when I get back. The random generation is barely holding on here. Look at this grave, how they're put. Hey, don't curse me, I'm just doing my job, man. I'm a professional ghostbuster and crypt destroyer. Okay, that door leads to another door. Yeah, these small skeletons are really proving a problem. Fumble them. Okay, this is what I was afraid of. Why did I go this way? Because now I'll be trapped inside the room. I'm out of energy. Well, I guess I could have killed him if I had energy. Ah. Made so many mistakes over there, a decorated dagger. You kidding me? I get one of these items, which is probably one of... Okay. Block chance, counter chance, fumble chance, bleed chance, armor penetration, decorated dagger. It's a unique dagger. Okay, let's see. What do I... Yeah, we have to manage the pain, otherwise we're not going to escape this place. Use one of that as well. Also, let's use one of the head. A little bit of intoxication, that never hurts, right? Oh, I forgot. This actually lowers your healing. Man. Okay, let's just keep going then. Enchantment scroll. Let's see what it gives us. Use it on your mace, by the way. Oh, block chance. Well, I guess that's decent. Remember, we didn't do the quest. We still have to complete. Destroy another site. So, we probably have to fight another skeleton or two. So... not particularly happy about this situation. Huh, why would they put the trap over there? That's a sneaky, sneaky move. By the way, in my perspective, I finished the dungeon this time. But I really needed to have more food on me, that's the only problem. Please, no more skeletons. Oh wow, this actually is a bigger dungeon. I could drink some of that for the pain. Man, these undead sure love their fine wines and beverages. Okay, creepy altars, but still no big creepy altar. Probably it's here. Still not healed. I have to do something about that as well. Okay, so I don't have to fight the last skeleton because he was destroyed by the trap. Oh, silly skeletons. Why are you always patrolling the place? Yeah. The developers need to fix some problems with the current version of the game, as you can see. It's not really that stable. Oh, this was the final place. Okay. We completed the quest without any major damages to our character. I mean, we didn't lose much health and we are in a good shape to go back. Actually, I think I have enough space to take some of the meat with me, so I'll not end the video here. I'll show you the great inventory management that I'm capable of. Yeah, so fully explore the dungeon. I was actually very lucky to find a lot of valuable items that are small. As small as in smaller size. Yeah, I think I can throw the identification scrolls. And we are full health right now. No injuries, no nothing. Which means I can take a lot of the antlers away. I was actually worried about this dungeon. Hey ghouls, it's daytime. Why is this here? Remember, if they eat their own kind, they get stronger, so watch out for that. Don't let them eat the corpses. Okay. We are doing this. Let's see, I can put this back here because it's the same price. Identification scroll, maybe I'll just put it over here so I remember it. Let's leave a bandage here. I should try to eat one right now. Yeah, even though I get poisoned, it's still kind of worth it. So I don't have to come back to this place anymore. Yeah, it's fine. I can lose this item. What am I doing? I can just use the identification on the ring. Oh, it has a damage reflection and healing. That's something else. So shock resistance, cooldown duration, health restoration, health healing efficiency 42, then damage reflection. Well, this has to be one of the better dungeons that I did in the beginning of the game. And now we can go home. Whew, that was a big adventure, but you got a lot of loot out of it. See you next time. Bye.